Yeah, thank you, Hare Krishna. Okay, so chapter 5, Karma Yoga, Action in Krishna Consciousness. This is one of my favorite chapters. So the question is, chapter 3 is called Karma Yoga and chapter 5 is called Action in Krishna Consciousness. Again, Karma Yoga, but the meaning is different. Action in Krishna Consciousness. Okay, so this is what we discussed yesterday. Transcendental knowledge about Krishna from 1 to 10, where I discussed with all of you that Bhagavad Gita was originally spoken by Krishna to Vivaswan, the sun god, who gave it to his son Manu, who gave it to his son Ikshvaku Maharaj, and who Ikshvaku Maharaj brought it to the earthly planet. But then eventually the succession was lost and Krishna came to re-establish it with Arjuna as the first hearer. And Krishna is the goal of all paths and the creator of Varnashrama system from 1 to 15. Ye yatha mam prapadyante. Like as one is surrendering to Krishna, Krishna reciprocates equally. Then Karma Yoga, he discussed. Karma nohi api bodhavyam. What is karma? What is akarma? And what is vikarma? 16 to 24th verse. Then sacrifices leading to knowledge, transcendental knowledge, jnana, vijnana, parantapaha. So whatever you do, whatever activity you're doing, surrender to Krishna. Or cultivate the knowledge about Krishna. So jnana means knowledge. Summary of transcendental knowledge, tadviddhi pranipatena. So Krishna said in 34th verse that if you want to understand the science, you have to approach an authority. 42nd verse is the last verse. My slides ended on 34th verse, but 42nd verse is the last verse, where Krishna ended the chapter by saying, therefore, get up in full knowledge and fight with determination. So he again encourages Arjuna to fight. So this chapter is about sannyasa or karma yoga. So two terms will be introduced in the first verse, karma sannyasa or karma yoga. Yat shreya is like, which one is better? The karma, then what is the difference between karma? So Krishna will say karma yoga is higher than karma sannyasa from 2 to 6 verse. Karma yoga vishishyate. The nishkam karma frees one from bondage. 7 to 16. Kurvan apina lipyate. Then liberation by focus on supreme. 17 to 29 verse. Gyatva mam shantim rakshati. Okay, Arjuna uvacha. As I said, most of the chapters are going to begin with question from Arjuna. Except chapter 12, where there is no question, only Krishna speaks. Okay, so Arjuna vacha. Sanyasam karmanam Krishna punar yogam cha samshashi yashreya etayor ekam tanme bruhi so nishchitam. Prabhu's student, Mannat, are you still here? Gaurangi, Mannat. Raise your hand if you're here. Because Prabhu said that he asked those children to read the shlokas. Okay, I'll only read.
I think they're not there, Mataji. I'm searching.
What? Okay. Ashwala, in the meantime, can you go over the chat also? Because there was a huge list of, I don't know, I couldn't see everything.
Yes.
Thank you. So, sannyasam karmanam Krishna punar yogam cha samshashi yashreya etayor ekam tanme bruhi so su nishchitam. Nishchitam means for sure. And su nishchitam means for sure. Like pura pakka, for sure. So Arjuna said, oh Krishna, first of all, you ask me to renounce work. And then again, you recommend work with devotion. Now, will you kindly tell me for definitely which of the two is more beneficial? So first, he's now again confused. Should I renounce or should I work with devotion? So two words, karma yoga and karma sannyasa. But the question is, why is Arjuna confused now? Because Krishna has already said that before, that working in devotion is better because you don't incur any sinful reaction when you work in devotion, right? Sarvam api asya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat. So the question is, why is Arjuna now confused? So the answer is, Krishna is going to say devotional service is better than dry mental speculation. And in chapter 2nd from verse 11 to 30, Krishna gave Arjuna the knowledge about the soul. That's jnana. Remember when he was answering the question about compassion, Arjuna said, I'm not going to fight because these are the objects of my compassion. All these people, my family, my grandfather, I'm not going to fight. So Krishna gave him the knowledge of soul, that you are actually applying your compassion in the wrong place. You should be applying the compassion to the soul, and soul never dies. So he gives the knowledge there. And then 31 to 37 verse, prescribed duty is explained, right? And that this is whatever sinful reaction is not going to be there because you're going to do your prescribed duty. The second question, second reason was slashed by Krishna. Then 42 to 45th verse, entanglement of soul due to fruitive activities is explained. 46 to 53rd verse, disentanglement by devotional service. So, Swalpam apyasya dharmasya trayate mahato bhayat comes here. Then third chapter, text 17 to 18, no duty for a person in knowledge. Krishna says over there that actually a person in knowledge has no duty to perform, has nothing. He said there, right, that I have nothing to do, but I still do, so as to lead the other, so as to set an example. And chapter 4, text 33, he explains all kinds of sacrificial work culminate in knowledge. And in the last verse of chapter 4, Krishna told Arjuna, get up and fight. So you see the confusion is coming from there, whether I should just cultivate knowledge or should I get up and fight in without attachment to the result of the fight. Sri Bhagavan Vacha. Gaurangi, yes, Gaurangi. Can you read? Hare Krishna.
Yes, Mataji. Sannyasa karma yoga sha niraharasya karva ubhavyu tayosa tu karma sannyasa ta karma yoga visheshati.
My God, Gaurangi, how old are you?
11.
Oh my God. Haribol. Thank you so much. So nice. Haribol. See, so two terms I can introduce here, karma sannyasa and karma yoga. See, sannyasa, karma, yogas cha. Cha means and. So karma sannyasa and karma yoga. So let's see the meaning. The personality of Godhead replied, the renunciation of work and work in devotion are both good for liberation. But of the two, work in devotional service is better than renunciation of work. Karma sannyasa means I take sannyas from activity. I don't work only. Karma yoga means I do the work, but I do the work in such a manner that the work itself connects me to Krishna. That's devotional service. Like I'm going to build a temple for Krishna, or I'm going to go and book distribute, or I'm going to preach Krishna about Krishna consciousness. So there's a work involved, right? So that's karma yoga. But karma sannyasa means I don't work only. I'm going to just renounce everything and sit and meditate. So no work with the active senses. So Krishna says both are okay, but of the two, devotional service is better. Okay, and this is, does anyone know this pastime, King Nriga? This comes in chapter 65 of Krishna book. I think it's 65. Does anyone know this pastime? What's happening here, that this is the karma kand versus devotional service is explained. Yes, Sita, Hare Krishna, you know the pastime? Very quickly.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. If I'm not wrong, the story is about King Mriga being very, giving away a lot of cows, if I remember the story correctly. And he gave away like millions and billions of cows, but the slide, I think, shows the fight between two Brahmins because accidentally one cow from one herd went to the other. He did apologize and said that he would give away, 100,000 or some other cows to make up for his mistake. But they did not agree, and I think they cursed him. And the first slide shows that he had to go and if I'm not wrong, the story is something about after his death, he was asked whether you want to enjoy the perks of what good deeds you have done, or you want to, take the one, but the punishment for the one sin. And I think he chose to take the sin punishment for the sin first. And the first slide shows Krishna and him being a lizard for a long, long time to make up for the one sin he did.
Yes. Thank you so much. You have attended our sessions before, or you read Prabhupada's book? if I may ask?
I am not booked before. I think I was reading a story for telling my child in the younger age, and I just remember the slide and I'm telling you this.
Okay. Thank you so much. Very nicely told. Yes. So see, someone can say that working, I have heard this many times now, that, okay, if I'm working on my prescribed duty or whatever, that is also not sure what is a prescribed duty, but I'm working. So work is worship. So I don't need to worship Krishna separately because I'm already worshiping Krishna by my work. This is the most common thing we hear when we preach. Okay, but that's not actually working for Krishna. That's working for our own self mostly. So there was this king called Nriga. His name is Nriga. He was very charitably disposed. Very, very charitably disposed. He used to perform a lot of sacrifices, but for his own satisfaction. Like if I do this sacrifice, then there will be good rain in the kingdom. If I do this sacrifice, then I will win the battle, like that. So that's karma kant. That's not devotional service. So once he was performing one such sacrifice, and he gave away so many cows in donation to the brahmanas. It is said that he gave away as many cows as there are number of stars in the sky, or there are number of dust particles on the planet Earth. So many cows he gave away. And each cow was very decorated with gold jewels, with fine fabric. So very pompously, like he was pampering the cows and he gave them. So one, what happened, that one Brahmana was walking with his herd after being donated, but accidentally one cow escaped and went to another herd, which was not yet donated by King Nriga. So King Nriga, so the Brahmana saw it, that, oh, this cow has gone. But by the time he went to King Nriga, King Nriga had also accidentally, unknowingly donated that another herd in which that already donated cow had joined to another Brahmana. So, but then this Brahmana said that this is my cow. This was donated to me. Give it away. And this Brahmana, this one is saying, no, this is given to me. So they were fighting, and King Nriga approached them with folded hands and said, Maharaj, this is my mistake. It was overlooked from my end. I take the responsibility. I will give you in return 100,000 cows, so 1 lakh cows. So please let this one cow go, and I will in return give you 1 lakh more cows. But they were still fighting, and they did not even pay a heed to what King Nriga said, and they cursed him. They cursed him that because you have not performed the sacrifice properly, you will have to suffer for it. So poor Nriga, he was performing the sacrifice to get some benediction, and he got cursed. And then when he left his body, this is the reason why he was brought to Yamaraj. A devotee, a pure devotee of Krishna does not see Yamadutas even in the dream. Prabhupada has very clearly mentioned it many, many times, has said it many, many times. 6th canto, 2nd chance, that Ajamila story is the proof. Devotee who is chanting Hare Krishna Maha Mantra sincerely does not see Yamadutas even in the dream. Forget about seeing them at the time of leaving the body. But he was brought in front of the Yamaraj just for this reason. And Yamaraj looked at his career and he said, Maharaj, you had a very good life. You have a lot of enjoyment waiting. There is one sin which you have to suffer for. So Maharaj, what do you want to do? Do you want to suffer first or you want to enjoy first? He said, better to suffer than I will enjoy nicely. He said, I want to suffer first. So the suffering was that he was made into a lizard in the well. But he asked Narad Muni to give him benediction. And Narad Muni said, you will stay there as a lizard. No one will ever be able to take you out, no matter how much they try, until Krishna gets there and comes. So you will be touched by the lotus hands of Krishna. So that's a benediction. So this is like millions of years past. He was still a lizard. And once Krishna's family was going, went on a picnic in this park, and his sons were playing, and they saw this lizard, and then they called the father. So the father came and picked out the lizard with his left hand, like it was nothing. So the problem is King Nriga then prays to Krishna and says that, even fruitive activities are so dangerous. You can become, do one mistake and then you have to suffer for it. So King Riga was fond of performing fruitive activities, sacrifice and charity. He did one mistake, what I explained, and he dissatisfying two brahmanas and inquiring. Inquiring or acquiring sinful result to become lizard for a very long time. Delivered by Krishna, King Riga confessing the futility of fruitive activities. Therefore, devotional service is the only auspicious activity for the soul. Really, we don't want to get trapped anywhere. Now, I want to give a case scenario to all of you, and you're gonna tell me that what happens. So let's say that there are two people. One person is Karma Sannyasi, you know, a sannyasi who's living in forest in Himalayas and doing severe austerities and trying to meditate and get self-realization. And another is a sannyasi who is traveling in very expensive airplanes, going to very big temples, traveling in very big cars, using modern technology, but he's talking about Krishna to use all this. Which one is the sannyasi? Which one do you think is a sannyasi? Please raise your hand. I'll give chance to two people. Is my question clear to everybody? Okay, Aditi Shetty. Aditi Venkatesh, sorry. Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, the sannyasi who is living in Himalayas will be the correct sannyasi.
Okay, thank you.
And the...
Sorry, Mataji, please unmute yourself. I accidentally muted you.
And the second sannyasi, he's just acting, he's just pretending that he's a sannyasi.
Thank you, Hare Krishna.
Thank you, Hare Krishna.
So anyone, Roshan, you are here. I'm going to make you a co-host. Okay, Roshan? Yes, Nitya Bimaraj, Hare Krishna. Yes, Mataji. Who is a sannyasi, who is not a sannyasi?
The sannyasi is the second one because he's going and preaching no matter whatever the technology is going in a high standard, but ultimately he's preaching about the Krishna. That is where he's spreading the words so that everybody is, the ratio is like one is to many. But if we take the first one, the ratio is one is to zero, just up to himself. So the second one is the sannyasi.
Yes, thank you so much. So we need a tiebreaker. Supraja Murali. You can break the tie for us. What do you think?
Yeah, pranams, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Second one is the real sannyasi because even though he's traveling, his mind is in Lord Krishna. So we are not sure about first one, even though he's doing meditation in Himalayas. But the second one, even though he's traveling and all, but his mind always dwells in Krishna, I think so. So he's the real sannyasi.
Thank you, my Krishna.
Yes.
So let's say that I, thank you. So let's say another scenario. Let's say that somebody is standing in front of State Bank of India and that person goes and stands in front of State Bank of India and says, "Oh, State Bank of India, I renounce you. I disown you." What will you call at such a person? Just goes in front of the bank and shouts like that. Yes, Mahesh Prabhu. Yes, Prabhuji. What will you call such person? Please unmute yourself.
Ma'am?
Hare Krishna.
Can I repeat the question?
Yes, okay. So, okay, I'm going to mute you, okay? So if someone is going in front of Bank of India and says that, okay, Bank of India, State Bank of India, I am renouncing you from this day. I am disowning you from this day. So you hear that person, what will you call that person? What will you call? Ling Sayantam Sharal. I'm sorry if I didn't say the name right. Hare Krishna. Yes, what will you call such person? Who you witness? Where is this person gone? Okay, Vishwateja, Hare Krishna. Oh, Mataji, Vishwateja. Yes, Mataji, what will you call such a person? Hare Krishna, you're
once, repeat the question, please.
Hare Krishna. If you witness, you're going on a street, you did some vegetable shopping, now you're going back home, and there's a bank of State Bank of India on your way back, and then this person is standing in front of State Bank of India and is saying, "Oh, State Bank of India, from this day, I am renouncing you. I am disowning you from this day, oh State Bank of India." And you see such a person. So what will come in your mind?
He's feeling an illusion. He's in the illusion, I think.
Yes. No, not think. There's nothing to think. He's the State Bank of India belongs to government. So he's a madman or she is whatever, right? Thank you, Mataji. So like that, when we are saying, I am going to get renounced from, I'm going to renounce this thing. I'm going to renounce that thing. Actually, what is ours? What is ours? What are we renouncing? If you really deeply think, that's what Rupa Goswami Prabhupada makes us think. That what is yours that you're trying to renounce? That is a mental concoction only, especially in this age group. There are five things which are prohibited. And taking a sannyas order by common mass of persons are prohibited. It's one of the things which is prohibited out of the five. And this is Rupa Goswami Prabhupada's version from Bhakti Rasamrita Sindhu. Prapanchikitaya buddhaya hari sambandhi vastunaha mumukshubhi parityago vairagyam falgu kathyate. Falgu is a false river, you know, a river which looks very deep. When you go and it looks, oh my God, this is such a deep river. But if you put your hand under the river water, then you will be able to feel the sand and it just goes through your fingers. So it means it looks deep, but it is very shallow. So when persons eager to achieve liberation renounce things related to the Supreme Personality of Godhead, thinking them to be material, their renunciation is called incomplete. So this is the point I want to make. So Srila Prabhupada was asked in Germany, I saw that video of interview. One reporter was interviewing Srila Prabhupada, that Prabhupada, you are coming to our countries and ISKCON is fabulously rich. He says that fabulously rich, you have so many cars, you're traveling in so many expensive airlines, you have so expensive buses which are going on. So Prabhupada said, yes, we have 9 buses. We go for book distribution and prasadam distribution to the villages in Germany every day. Yes, so, and you're being seated in such a nice place, Vyasasan, that devotees used to make. So are you a sannyasi? Isn't it sannyasi used to be the one who has only one pair of cloth, one begging from home to eat? Prabhupada said, all this belongs to Krishna. He was speaking in the mic. This mic actually belongs to Krishna. So why not use it for Krishna? Why should I renounce it artificially when I can very well use it for Krishna's service? So that renunciation is complete. Or Prabhupada, Rupa Goswami Prabhupada says another verse, Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe Yukta Vairagya Uchyate. So Nirbandha Krishna Sambandhe, I am renouncing something which actually has a relationship with Krishna, is not complete. But if I am using that thing in a way that I use it for Krishna's service, that is Yukta Vairagya Uchyate. That is called as a real Yukta and Vairagya. Okay, so that is where Prabhupada was different. So Karma Yoga or Karma Sannyasa, I hope the two terms are clear now, whether I should work in devotional service or I should take retirement from the work itself. Oh, Gaurangi, you're here? Gaurangi, you stay up if you're here. Ashwara, is she here or she's gone? Gyanehe sa nitya. Okay, I'll. Gyanehe sa nitya sannyasi yona dveshti na kankshati. Nirdvanto hi mahabaho sukham bandha pramuchyate. One who neither hates nor desires the fruits of his activities is known to be always renounced. Such a person, liberated from all dualities, easily overcomes material bondage and is completely liberated. Oh, mighty armed Arjuna. So this is a very crash course class, right? Otherwise, each and every verse, we can spend weeks and weeks of discussion. Each and every verse. So here, so many words are introduced. Dualities. duality is the function of the mind. It is not the function of the intelligence. It is definitely not the function of the soul. Duality means I like something, I don't like something. I accept something, I reject something. I have friends and I have enemies. So see two opposite things, hate and desire. So the one who neither hates or desires the fruits of his activities is always known to be renounced. Krishna is not saying that one who does not work. He's very much focused on his discussion to one who is not attached to the fruit of the work, but is very well working. Daksha. Prabhupada said devotee is a daksha. Daksha means perfect. Whatever a devotee does is perfect. Perfectly done. If they are working, they should not be like, oh, now I've become Krishna devotee. I have nothing to do because I have to go back to Krishna. So why should I study? Why should I take care of my family? Why should I? That's laziness. It's not a devotee. According to Srila Prabhupada, that person is validating its own laziness using shastras as evidence. Very, very dangerous. A devotee is always very careful. Such a person liberated from all dualities easily overcomes material bondage. The material bondage of birth, death, old age, disease are the three secondary sufferings of adhibhautik, adhyatmik and adhidevik is because we are attached to the dualities of the world. And is completely liberated. So renounce the results and not the action. That's what Krishna wants, and that's what Krishna will make him make happy. That will make Krishna happy. So this is Srila Haridas Thakur. He's our Nam Acharya. Haridas Thakur makes his appearance in Chaitanya Charitamrita, in Chaitanya Lila. Srila Haridas Thakur used to chant 3 lakh names. Of 3 lakh rounds of Hare Krishna Mahamantra every day. You know, like how Srila Prabhupada told us, chant minimum 16 rounds of Hare Krishna Mahamantra every day. Like that, Srila Haridas Thakur used to chant 3 lakh rounds a day. Practically, it comes out to be 22 hours a day of chanting because he had so much taste. Chanting has different stages, Nam Aparad, Nam Abhas, and Nam Shuddhanam. So he was in Shuddhanam stage. But the local Qazi of the place where he was living became very envious that how can he be so saintly? How can he get so famous just by chanting and sitting in his bhajan kuti? So he wanted to defame Srila Haridas Thakur. So he played a trick. Haridas Thakur sent a prostitute to, the Qazi, he sent a prostitute to Haridas Thakur's bhajan kuti and to distract him. So that he will be caught and then he will get defamed. His reputation of being a very saintly person will be tainted. So she went and Haridas Thakur told her, "Oh, very nice you have come here." She went in the middle of the night and she said, "I want to speak to you." Haridas Thakur said, "Yes, very nice. Thank you so much for coming. Actually, I have a vow of chanting 3 lakh names. So I still have so few rounds left. Please sit down in front of me and the minute I'm done with my rounds, I'm going to talk to you." So Haridas Thakur was chanting and the prostitute was waiting. So the morning came and then she left. And then he said, "I'm sorry, I wasn't able to talk to you at all. Tomorrow you come again. And then we'll talk, okay? I'll try to finish my rounds early." So she comes next night. And same thing happened. Haridas Thakur is chanting, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. And the prostitute is waiting. And she goes away, morning breaks. And again, Haridas Thakur apologizes. And then the third day, then he says, "Okay, you come again tomorrow. Tomorrow, pakka, I promise. You know, I'm sorry, what can I do? I have a vow." So she comes and then she sees the same thing repeating. This time she gets a little critical about it. So she is like, "What is it more important to you? Wherever I go, I am so beautiful. Everybody leaves what they're doing to come to me. And I am sitting in front of you all night and you are not even looking at me. What is it that you're doing? I'm very curious to find out what is it that you're doing." So Haridas Thakur said, "Yes, that was the moment I was waiting for. I could have gone the first day itself, But I waited for you to ask me this question, that what is it that is more relishing than associating with the opposite gender? What is more relishing? Then Haridas Thakur gives her the initiation, and she shaves her head, sits in the bhajan kutir in front of the tulsi plant and chants Hare Krishna, and Haridas Thakur leaves. So that is the effect of associating with Krishna, or a pure devotee, not mithyachara, pure devotee of Krishna. That one moment, sulpam api, what is the shloka? What is the verse? What is Aishwarya? What is
the verse? Neha Vikramana
Swasti.
Neha Vikramana Swasti.
Yes, thank you. So I have scholars to help me. Yes. So Trayate Mahato Bhayat. So what is it? Trayate Mahato Bhayat. No, not that. No, not even Neha Vrikasya. He says one moment association with a pure devotee.
Sadhu Sangha, Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Shastra Hoi, Lava Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoi.
Yes, thank you. Lava Matra Sadhu Sangha, Sarva Siddhi Hoi, Lava Matra. So Lava, this is a division of the time. It is given in third canto of Srimad Bhagavatam, how time is divided. So Lava is even a fraction of a millisecond. That time is called as, that measurement of time is called as lava. So even that much time of association with a pure devotee is enough to make one's life perfect. It's so potent. And this is another very nice verse, that how we can work with for Krishna without being attached to the fruit. Brahmani adhyaya karmani sangam tratta karoti yaha lipyate nasa papena padmam putram Padma Patram Ivam Bhasa. So Padma Patram Ivam Bhasa. Padma means lotus. Patram means leaf. Ivam Bhasa means remains untouched. One who performs his duty without attachment, surrendering the results onto the Supreme God, is not affected by sinful action, as the lotus leaf is untouched by water. So we can remain in the world and work for Krishna, and at the end of the life, go back to Krishna. Not like go back to another animal life or another this body or that body. Mm-mm. So we can do that by becoming Krishna conscious. And I'm going to show you this Prabhupada's video. This is Prabhupada in San Francisco, Golden Gate Park. It used to be called as Hippie Hill in 1960s and 70s, where all the hippies of California used to stay. Okay, let's see. Oh, I'll have to share my audio. Some, just one second. Hippies in America, is he not a sannyasi? Does he not look like a sannyasi? Is he associating with them, or is he giving his association to them? So he is taking up all the trouble to preach Krishna consciousness, and that is a real sannyasi, not the person who goes and hides himself in the Himalayas for the fear of being caught in Maya. And what is the vision of a sannyasi? How does a devotee, a pure devotee, look like? What is the symptoms? Like, remember, we discussed this in chapter 2. And here...
Mataji, Gaurangi is with us.
Okay, thank you. Gaurangi, can you read?
Yes, Mataji.
Vidyavani sampanne brahmane gavihasani shunye chayvashu pakecha pandetas madarshana. Very nice, thank you. So Vidya Vinaya Sampanne Brahmani Gavi Hastini. So you see, when I distribute Bhagavad Gita on the street, I ask people, what do you mean by word humble? So we get different answers, right? Humble means that I am able to take insult very nicely. Humble means that I am very pious in my activities. I get up early, I take care of my children. Humble means I do aarti in my temple. Or humble means this, humble means I whatever. We have heard it all. But what does Bhagavad Gita say humble means? Humble means the humble sage, by virtue of true knowledge, sees with equal vision a learned and gentle Brahmana, a cow, an elephant, a dog, and a dog eater. So that is the meaning of the word humble. That person has a vision of knowledge. Vision of knowledge, and that is why the person is able to see the soul in everybody. He's not attached to the dress, whether it's a cow or a elephant or a dog or a dog eater. Different categories. Person in the mode of ignorance, mode of passion. So cow, it means mode of goodness. Elephant and means goodness and passion mixed. Dog is only passion and ignorance. Dog eater is pakka ignorance. Like that, whatever. So it is, that person is called as a humble sage. Not the person who's whatever in the world definition is. Pandita Samadarshinaha. Samadarshina means equal vision. What is equal? What is equal in the vision? The soul. That person is seeing the soul and the super soul in the heart. So, Garangi, you want to do again? Okay, do it.
यही संस्प्रजा भोगा दुखियो बनैवते आभ्यांतवंत कौन्तेया नते शूरमते बुद्धा.
Thank you, Garangi. See, this is a very important verse. An intelligent person does not take part in the sources of misery, which are due to contact with the material senses. O son of Kunti, such pleasures have a beginning and end, and so the wise man does not delight in them. So this is, again, Krishna is reinforcing that work for me. Don't work for your own sense gratification. Because by working for me, first of all, you will not have any sinful reaction. Second of all, you will become a humble sage. Third, your senses will be controlled. And he's saying, intelligent person does not take part in the sources of misery, which are due to contact with the material senses. This is like everybody, 99.9% of the people across the world are working. Why? Because I have a desire to satisfy my senses. I have a desire to eat certain thing. I have a desire to work certain thing. I have a desire to drink something. I have a desire to have a family with this thing. I have a desire. So many colors of desires are there, but none of them are making anybody happy. There is a verse. Oh, I have to tell you all. Chaitanya Charitamrita, there is this one Brahmana who prays to Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Kama dinam katina kalita palita durini desha, tesham jata maina karuna na kripa na pashanti. This kama dinam katina kalita palita durini desha. Oh my God, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, I have served my senses day in and out so hard. But they are never satisfied. Neither my own senses are satisfied, nor the people that I'm serving are satisfied. Tesham jata mai na karuna. No mercy, na kripa. No benedictions, no thank yous, no gratitude. Na shanti, no peace. Now I'm going to surrender unto you. Please take care of me. And then Bhakti Vinod Thakur, he sings, Bhajahu re mana shri nanda nandana abhe charanara vindare. So there, chapala sukha laba lagire. Chapala sukha means flickering happiness. Like, I'm working so hard. I'm trying to satisfy myself. I'm trying to satisfy my family. I'm trying to satisfy my nation, my society, my work. But nobody is happy. Neither am I getting happiness. But I'm working. So I'm only getting a flickering happiness. It comes and it goes. So now I have a desire to understand the real happiness. Only that person will be able to get mercy. So here is saying that the sense enjoyment is actually a source of misery. And this is the example. So we have five knowledge acquiring senses and five working senses, right? Five knowledge acquiring senses is my eyes. I look at the things and I acquire knowledge. Ears, hearing the things and acquiring knowledge. Tasting, tongue, to taste and acquire knowledge about the subject. Smelling and touch. So let's see. These are the moth. I don't know if you all have seen in a rainy season on a hot lamp, because the moth has a very strong vision sense, can't control. So they go and get attracted to the sun, to the hot lamp. Then what happens? They are attracted to the light, but then they get fried. It's so hot that they just die there, right? So sense of vision, going to satisfy sense of vision, death. This is a deer. A deer is very attracted to hearing a nice flute, which is played by a hunter. So the hunter is playing the flute, and the deer is very happily walking towards the hunter because it has a very strong sense of hearing. What happens? The hunter traps the deer. Okay. The bee has a very strong sense of smell. Very strong. So goes in the flower and is trying to suck the nectar out of the flower. And in the evening, when the sun falls and the flower closes, the bee gets trapped. So sense of smell. And the fish has a very big sense of taste. There is so much food available in the water, in the river, in the ocean, so much food. But the fisherman throws a bait with the food hanging. Fish goes to taste that, and what happens? Dies. And then elephant, such a strong animal, such a big animal. How it is caught? What is the trap? The trap is that there is a she elephant. The hunter trains the she elephant to entice the elephant. So that she's walking and the elephant is walking behind her. And then she's trained to go around a pit. But then he falls in the pit, which is covered by leaves and branches. So he gets caught just by trying to satisfy the sense of touch. The thing is that in animal kingdom, they generally have one sense which is very strong, right? Which is a reason for their death or being caught up. But in human beings, all the senses are equally strong. See how much we are entangled. Bhakti Vinod Thakur prays, Sharira avidya jal, chode indriya tahe kal, avidya jal. It's a network of ignorance. Chode indriya tahe kal, the senses are trying to trap. Prabhupada uses these words. If you read, when you read Prabhupada's book, and you must read Prabhupada's books, Prabhupada says clutches of Maya. You know, it's like as if you're clutched by something, or shackles of Maya. So Prabhupada writes like that. It gives a vision or an imagination that how much. So if I have a sense of enjoying and I want to procure money by illegal means or legal means, a person will do anything. But a devotee of Krishna understands the futility of this. And this is a peace formula. This is the shloka, which is called peace. Okay, my guru, Varangi. Go ahead.
Bhoktaram yagatapasama sarvalokai maheshwaram suhirdam sarvabhutanam gyatvamam shanti vrachati.
Thank you. See, Bhokta Ram Yagana Tapasam Sarva Loka Maheshwaram Suhirdam Sarva Bhutanam Gyatva Mam Shanti Rachati. Bhokta means enjoyer. And means Bhokta Ram Yagana Tapasam means I am the enjoyer of all your sacrifices and austerities. Where? Is he enjoyer only in earth planet? Is he the enjoyer only in India? Is he the enjoyer only in Vrindavan, Dwarka, Mathura? Sarva Loka Maheshwaram. All the universes. Suhirdam. There are three kinds of friendship described in second chapter of Bhagavad Gita. Suhrat, Mitra, Bandhu. So Suhrat means best friend. So, and Bandhu is official friendship. And Mitra is a friend. So Suhrat means best friend. So Suhrat Sarva Bhutanam. Krishna is saying, I am the best friend of all the living entities. Gyatva Mam Shantim Rachati. One who understands this only can get the peace. So the sages who know me as the ultimate purpose of all sacrifices and austerities, the Lord, Supreme Lord of all planets and demigods, and the benefactor and well-wisher of all living entities, attain peace from the pangs of material misery. So that is the only way if I can re-establish my relationship with Krishna. See, in Krishna consciousness, the relationship between the other one another is not prohibited. It's not prohibited. Prabhupada was performing marriage ceremonies of his disciples. Prabhupada was opening gurukuls for the children born to those disciples. And Prabhupada was training brahmacharis. Prabhupada was giving sannyas order. Prabhupada was doing everything. But it has to be under the regulation where Krishna is in the center. Otherwise, it becomes a burden. After some time, the relationship is a burden. But in Krishna consciousness, we enjoy so much. You see, I have never met Aishwarya so far, but I can't wait to meet her now. And I think same is for her. And there's so many other people who have come along with us in all these courses from June till now. We have never met in person, but now we can't wait to be together and do pilgrimage. So that is why, because Krishna is in the center. Okay. So this is a summary. Please don't leave. I have a very revolutionary video to show all of you today. Whosoever has watched it may leave. So Karma Sannyasa and Karma Yoga, which is better? Yes, Shreya, which one is more better? Which one is more appropriate? Krishna says Karma Yoga is better than Karma Sannyasa. 2-6, Karma Yoga Vishishyate. The Nishkam Karma Yoga is even better. Means Nishkam means one who is working, but who is not taking the shelter of the results. Even 6th chapter, 1st verse says like that, right? Anashrita karyam karma, anashrita karma phalam karyam karma karoti saha yasa sannyasi cha yogi na cha akriya cha na niragnir. So anashrita karyam karam. Ashrita means shelter. Anashrita means not taking the shelter. One who does not take the shelter of the results of activities but performs the activities is a real sannyasi. Not the person who does not light the fire and does not perform any activity. So nishkam karma means anashrita karyam karam. Not taking the shelter of the fruit, but doing the work for the sake of Krishna. Kurvan api na lipyate means I do not get any sinful reaction. Then liberation by focus on Krishna. Gyatva mam shantim rachati. From 17 to 29th verse. This is a nutshell. So I have been told that many of the people are not taking the quiz. Please take quiz. Prabhu is putting all the slides and lot of videos over there for all of you to watch and download. Please make account. Understand Gita18.teachable.com and that is the only way that you will be getting certificates. And if we are not able to answer all the questions, so you can email us ugenglish20@gmail.com and you can watch the recording. My classes are not uploaded yet, but I'm working on it. And chapter 5 verses to memorize 18, 22 and 29. Okay, so let's see the video and then we'll break up in the rooms. If someone has to leave after the video, please feel free to leave. This is from 3rd Canto Bhagavatam, chapter number 31, Movement of the Living Entity. And it was done in UK. Can you hear? Aishwarya.
Yes, Mother, we can hear.
Yes, Mother. And when the body is the bomb, usable, then the body is finished. And the soul again enters another body. This is called as five instruments. What is the next body you are going to get? You must have information. Thank you.
dream?
You're actually in the middle of the workshop right now, sleeping. This is your first lesson.
So nice, huh? This is done by UK. Okay, so I have a question in polling. Let's see. Okay, please answer this question for me from today's class, and then I have one more question. I'm opening up the chat for. In Shloka Vidya Vinaya Sampanne, the humble sage is defined as a personality with equal vision for, it's 5th chapter, 18th verse. As per Shloka Bhoktaram Yagna Tapasam, Krishna is the teacher of even Brahma, gives pleasure to Mother Yashoda, only enjoy for all sacrifices and austerities. The video link is there for all of you already in the Teachable. So please go make account. The video is already there and there are many more videos. Okay, I'm gonna give few more minutes. Please vote. Only 30% of the class has voted so far. Okay, I'm gonna end the polling in some time. Can I make an account? I'm 8. Yes. Mataji, how to vote? You see the polling in my on your screen, right? You have to press the answer. I have heard people who are using their mobiles are having issues. So it has to do something with the mobile. If you're using iPad, computer, laptop, it should work. I have a question. Yes, I'm going to give chance for the questions. Hi, ma'am. Please give me your number. So you can email me ugenglish20@gmail.com and I will reply. Aishwarya, can you please keep checking the chat also? Okay, I'm going to end the polling. Only 57%.
Yes,
okay, thank you, Aishwarya. And Roshan, you too. In Shloka, Vidya Vinaya Sampanne, this humble sage is defined as a personality with equal vision for. I'll bring the verse. So its answer is what is maximally answered, right? Brahmana, cow, elephant, dog, and dog eater. There's a spelling mistake there. So you see, I'll show you the slide. 518. This is the one. You can see? A humble sage by virtue of true knowledge sees with equal vision a learned and gentle brahmana, a cow, an elephant, a dog, and a dog eater. Okay, as per Shloka Bhoktaram Yagna Tapasam, Krishna is, the correct answer is the only enjoyer of all sacrifices. Only enjoyer. So Bhoktaram Yagna Tapasam is not the teacher of, yeah, he is the teacher of Brahma, but he is not according to this verse. That is not the meaning. Gives pleasure to Mother Yashoda, that is true, but that not according to this verse. Most expert in doing yagyas like Ashwamedh Yagya. That is also, I can say, true in one sense, but not according to verse 29 of chapter 5. So you have to read the whole question, okay? Thank you. Now there's one more. I want some promises made today because of Adhika Mas. Tell me, how many of you are going to pitch in? In Purushottam month, I promise to chant Hare Krishna Maha Mantra daily. One round, that means 108 times. 1 to 4 rounds, Every day, 4 to 8 rounds. One round is 108 times. 8 to 16 rounds, more than 16 rounds. Tell me, I want to know. Every day I will ask. I think from tomorrow is going to be a follow-up question of this. Please do it. What is the loss? There is no loss. There is no tax. It takes one round, takes 5 to 7 minutes in 24 hours. Please keep a count. Please chant. Okay, very nice. Thank you. Please vote for a few more minutes. It's 1:30. Okay, 60% of the class voted. Please, I want to see 100%. Oh, because I did not put the option for I will not chant. Because I don't want that. I'm selfish. Okay. So I will end the polling in a few more seconds. 68% class voted. Okay, I'll share the results. So 93 people are saying one round. Thank you for doing it. Slowly try to increase. 1 to 4 rounds. Thank you so much. 4 to 8 rounds, 7 people. 8 to 16, 9. More than 16, 7. Hari Bol. So please chant. It's my genuine request. I am not charging you money. I am not asking you to for secret things. I'm openly telling what Srila Prabhupada told, that please chant Hare Krishna and please be happy. There's no downside of chanting, no side effects, and the effects are amazing. Okay, can anyone do Kirtan for 2 minutes and then we will split out in breakout rooms for 10-15 minutes. Can anyone do Kirtan? Can you please raise hand? Please only raise hand if you are listening to my question and you want to do Kirtan. Then I'll unmute you and you do it. Ashrit Yaram, Hare Krishna. Please unmute yourself, Ashrit. Okay, he's having some problem. Ruchi Mumbai, Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna, Hari Bol Mataji, Hare Krishna.
So Mataji, you can do the Harinam for 2 minutes. Okay, let's listen to Ruchi Mataji. Welcome. Yes, Mataji, please start.
जयो श्री कृष्णा चैतन्य प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधरा श्रीवासादि गौर भक्त वृंदा हरे कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा 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 हरे 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 रामा 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 हरे हरे
थैंक यू माताजी सो नाइस She sang so well, right? You're a devotee, huh? So I'm going to break out the rooms for 15 minutes. Roshan and Aishwarya, I have a request. Please teach how to chant on the beads. Please bring your beads and teach them for first 2 minutes. And then we can take questions. So 15 minutes, I'm going to bring you all back, okay? How many people are there? 198 divided by 360. I'm gonna make two rooms. Okay, I'm gonna create the rooms. There we go. So please teach how to chant. Aishwarya, also make sure you and Roshan are not on the same class together. You have your own room and he has his own room. Okay, Haribol, whoever is staying behind, I'm gonna first teach you how to chant and then we will take the questions. So we have a japa bead. Can you all hear me? Still people are leaving, coming. So we have the japa bead, and this bead in the center is called Krishna bead. And this is a bead which witnesses the chanting. So we don't chant on this bead. We start chanting from this bead. And we use the middle finger and the thumb. We don't use the index finger because Prabhupada said index finger is for pointing people. So use the middle finger and the thumb, and we chant prayer first. Do you all know Jai Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaura Bhakti Vrinda? So we ask for benediction for our chanting and forgiveness for not chanting properly. And then I chant whole mantra, Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare on every bead. One bead over, then I go to the next bead. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. Not like Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, and then go to the next bead for Hare Ram, Hare Ram, Ram Ram, Hare Hare. No. Full mantra has to be chanted on each bead. Start from here. If I'm starting from this bead, this is the last bead. And if I do another round, then the last bead becomes the first bead. So I turn. I don't cross over. Okay, like that we do 16 times in 24 hours minimum. Okay, I'm happy to take the questions. Does anyone have any questions? Supraja Murali. You are allowed to unmute yourself, but when you unmute, please announce your name and I will tell you who can ask question first. Yes, Supraja Mataji, you have a question? Hare Krishna. Supraja Mataji, you are unmuted. Okay, Rashmi Rajesh Mataji.
Hare Krishna Mataji, my name is Rashmi. Through the entire process of today's class, you had mentioned that there are three levels of attaining when you are chanting. One is the offensive, there are three. Well, can you please explain? I have just started chanting 16 okay. rounds for past 1 week, so I don't know which level I am in.
Well, we are in Nama Parad only. Yes, thank you so much. So the three levels, one is called Naam Aparad, means offensive chanting. Means I'm chanting, but I'm committing offense. There are 10 types of offenses. And then chanting, when I become purified and if I'm chanting properly, chanting means hearing. Like I'm chanting and my ear is hearing. There is no mind. There's no imagination. Chant and hear. And that's a meditation. So when I'm chanting and purely chanting, then the next level is Naam Abhas. Naam Abhas is where almost all the offenses are gone. Almost all the offenses are gone. Like for example, when the sun is going to come up in the sky, you see the crimson color, right? There's some indication that now the sun is going to come up. So that is Naam Abhas. And Shuddha Naam is the stage when one is chanting in pure name, no offenses. The 10 offenses are first offenses to blaspheme the devotees of the Lord who have dedicated their lives. I should make a slideshow and share. Who have dedicated their lives for the propagation of the holy
name. Mom, you're muted, I think, so we can't hear you.
You should be able to hear me. Rajesh, Rashmi Mataji, you are able to hear me?
Yes, I am able to hear you, Mataji. I am able to hear.
Okay. So, first is to blaspheme the devotees of the Lord. Can you tell this child that the problem is in their end? who have dedicated their lives for the propagation of the holy name. Second offense is to consider the names of demigods like Lord Shiva, Brahma, to be equal to or independent of the holy name. So they're like that, they're 10 offenses. Third is to disobey the orders of the spiritual master. Fourth is to blaspheme the Vedic literature or literature in person to the Vedic version. Fifth is to consider glories of chanting Hare Krishna as an imagination. Sixth, to give some mundane interpretation to the holy name of the Lord. Seventh, to commit sinful activities on the strength of chanting Hare Krishna. Eighth, to consider chanting Hare Krishna as one of the auspicious ritualistic ceremonies mentioned in the Vedas as Karmakand. Nine, to instruct the faithless person regarding the glories. 10, not to have complete faith in chanting and to maintain mental attachments even after understanding so many instructions on this matter. And it is also an offense to chant inattentively. So these are 10 offenses, and each offense has, we can explain and spend one month.
I have started chanting early in the morning at 3 o'clock. Right. But I am not actually used to getting up so early. So sometimes I feel that I'm getting lost and I'm trying to get back to chanting, and I may be committing a lot of offense while doing so. I don't know how to rectify, but I'm trying my level best to chant 16 rounds early in the morning without any disturbance. It's my aim.
Thankful to you for trying and taking the shelter of the holy name. Mataji, try your best. Try to make sure that you have enough sleep. Try to make sure that the environment where you are chanting, you don't have distraction. You're not chanting in the middle of the house where you can see that, oh, I have to do this also, that also, that also. So you have to make an environment. One is advice to make an environment in the house where there is no distraction. Preferably chant with devotees. You know, at 5 a.m., we have Japa session live every day in the temple. You can dial in or join from the website, iskonmangaluru.com. Or you can put Srila Prabhupada's soft chanting when you're chanting. And try to chant and hear. The relationship is between mouth and ear. Slowly, slowly, I'm 100% sure you'll be fine. Krishna is Bhavagrahi Janardana. Krishna is Krishna extracts the essence. It's the action itself is not so important, but Krishna wants to see how sincere I am.
Thank
yes,
you,
Mataji. Krishna. Yes, Supraja Murli, Mataji, I feel bad. You're not able to unmute. Ishan, you have a question? Nobody has a question? Pallavi, no question today?
What will be in that link? What will be in that link? You told. You said the quizzes link.
The teachable link? Yes, there are so many things. That's a treasure box. When you open the box, you get so much treasure. There's a chapter PDF. All the slides that I'm presenting are there. And then there's so many videos that Prabhu is uploading each chapter. And then there are quizzes. And at the end, when you take,
Krishna,
you can print out your Hare Krishna, you can print out your certificate at the end from that link.
Hare Krishna Mataji, Pallavi.
Pallavi, yes, Pallavi Mataji. Yes, Hare
Hello?
Krishna. Yes, I can hear you.
Hare. Mataji, Hare, my question was, actually it's quite funny that to vanish my ahankara, my pride, I want to read the Bhagavad Gita. But then, when I am reading that, I have no pride that, yes, I am reading something and I am doing so much work on myself. See, you guys are not doing nothing. When those who are with me, I guess, I pretend like that I am reading so much and you are doing nothing. See how great I am. That's kind of feeling. So this pride has changed from one type to another. So how to conquer these things? What is the use then?
Very nice. One second. Is it necessary to chant Maha Mantra after bath or can do any time? You can do any time, but it's preferable after bath because you'll not fall asleep. There is no set rule or regulation. Pallavi Mataji, your question is how to vanish the pride, right? We cannot get rid of the ego. Cannot. We can purify the ego from false to true. Soul has an ego. You know, all the servants of Krishna who are associating with Krishna, Krishna's friends and all, they're very proud to be friends of Krishna. Right? They don't want to be friends with anyone because Krishna so shows superpowers. He's a superhero. So they're very like happy to be associated with Krishna and they're very proud. You know who's my friend? Krishna. You see, in the pastime of Dhenukasura, the donkey demon, when all the fruit, there was a smell of the fruit in the tree, in the orchard, and the boys, the gopas, got attracted to eat that, taste that fruit. So, but some friends warned, don't go there because Dhenukasura is there and he will slash. So the rest of the people said, why are you so being so coward? You know who's our friend? Krishna. Krishna will take care. Let's go. So see, they are very proud of being associated with Krishna. So the pride, proud has to be, it's internal though. We cannot like go on showing, oh, you are such a downtrodden person and I look at me. But you have to be proud of yourself, who you are. If you are becoming a Krishna devotee, oh my God, you should be eternally proud of yourself. I am proud of myself. I don't need anyone to tell me, oh, you are so good or you are so bad. I'm already proud because I am happy in Krishna consciousness. But the other part of your question is, now what is the use? Because I'm thinking other people are less important. You know, when I first started chanting Hare Krishna, and in the temple in morning darshanarti time, there are Govindam prayers. They're Sanskrit prayers. So Govindam Adi Purusham Tamaham Bhajami. So there are two prayers which are sung at that time. Venum Kalantam. So when I started going to temple, Mangalore only, and slowly, slowly I memorized the verses and I started singing with the prayers in the morning. And in my heart, I was getting proud. But see, some people are not even able to understand that what is going on, and see, I'm chanting Sanskrit prayers. But then I also got this thing that you're getting in your heart, and I prayed to the deities that what am I becoming? Man tumi kibir Vaishnava. You know, what kind of a Vaishnava are you, my dear mind? What kind of a Vaishnava are you becoming? Memorizing some small things and you're becoming like, oh, you're superior to the person who's not chanting? What kind of, so you have to beat your mind up and pray to Krishna, basically. So slowly, 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 I saw that, okay, I have no more proud. I don't have it inside me anymore, but I had it. I remember it. So you have to pray to Krishna in that way, and you have to beat up your mind. That what kind of a Vaishnava are you? What kind of a devotee are you? That's the internal dialogue you have to have. And then Krishna will help you. Okay?
Thank you.
Hare Krishna. If I may ask. How many rounds are you chanting, Pallavi?
Sorry. I'm chanting one in morning and one in evening.
Very nice. So you have a long way to go.
So I'll increase rounds. It, but...
Yes, very nice. And you are a medical student or you're working?
Yes, ma'am. No, I'm working. I'm dentist.
Very nice. So see, you can also... So anybody else has any questions? Thanks. Hare Krishna. Yes, Mataji. Rashmi Mataji, you have a question?
Yes, Mataji. How long will it take to move from one level of chanting to the other level?
One moment. Depends on how much I'm surrendering. Remember yesterday I showed Prabhupada's video?
Yes, I remember.
It depends on us. How much chanting has to be done as a genuine cry for the child, for the mother. You know, a child, people are trying to pacify the small baby by giving the milk, by giving the toys, by changing the clothes, by changing diaper, by rocking, by taking them out. But the minute the mother grabs the child, the child stops crying, right? So that is how one should chant, Prabhupada recommended.
Okay, but are you saying that by having the Prabhupada's chanting in a low volume by the side of when I am chanting, will it rectify my chanting or will it help me?
It will help you. It will definitely help you. Prabhupada is a pure devotee. You see, I was there once in inter-religious faith meeting. What happened was there were leaders from different faiths, Jewish or Muslim or Christian, and one of the ISKCON leaders. They were all sitting on a podium, and the meeting was about to begin. But the one thing that caught my attention was that the priest had a rosary in the hands, the Muslim priest had the beads in the hand, And our leader, of course, had japa beads in the hand. The Jewish leader had japa beads in the hand. So trying to connect with God through the sound vibration is universal in everywhere. Ishan, 1 second. So is universal everywhere. So chanting and connecting with God is actually not new. It's there everywhere. We're just not able to connect and come together. So Prabhupada's vibration is very pure. He's a pure devotee. And I can share Prabhupada's lecture on Hare Krishna Mahamantra. People share, I have seen, that's why one reason why I block the chat every day is that they are sharing this singer's Hare Krishna chanting, that singer's Hare Krishna chanting. And Srila Prabhupada has strictly forbidden all that. He said chanting has to be heard from the lips of a pure devotee. You see that how that prostitute was hearing from the mouth of Srila Haridas Thakur and it transformed her heart. Like that it happens. But if it is heard from a non-devotee who is singing to earn some name and fame in this world, then it is like drinking a milk which is touched by the lips of a serpent. It's still milk, but it is poisonous. So it helps because it transforms the heart. The vibration goes in the heart. You must already be doing something. That's why you are still doing it, right?
Yes, yes.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
I was terribly anxious about everything in my life. Somehow something has brought it down by chanting 16 rounds. I don't know what it is, but somehow I feel some kind of a security.
Yes.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Yes, Rashmi. No, I'm sorry.
I can't explain.
Yes.
Yeah. No, but thank what it is, but still.
Please share your experience with the whole class. Yes, Aditi, Mataji. Yes, Mataji.
Mataji, I remember telling Srila Prabhupada preaching about sattvic diet. Can you please just give a brief about it?
Sattvic diet, that's going to come in chapter 16, Divine and Demoniac Qualities. So sattvic diet means diet in mode of goodness. Like food has three functions. Bala, to give strength. Ayu, to increase the age. And sattva, to give happiness. These are the three functions a food has according to Bhagavad Gita. Bala, ayu, sattva. So the food which is in the mode of goodness is juicy, fatty, full of fruits and vegetables and is of course offered to Krishna. If it is cooked, it is a very nice vegetable curry cooked, very nice fruit juice, very nice chapati, not offered to Krishna is not sattvic. It could be very nice for somebody, but it is not sattvic. Krishna makes it pure. And when one eats such a food, prasadam, then it acts on the memory, the cells of the brain. And then one is able to understand Krishna consciousness better because you're more alert that way. You know, the diseases, Alzheimer's disease, the memory, the degeneration of the memory cells, Alzheimer's disease, they are doing, there is a proposed hypothesis that actually the brain cells are damaged by the gut because the gut, I don't want to go into embryology, but the intestine and the brain cells are formed from the same derm. And when they migrate, one part becomes the brain, other part becomes the intestine. So it depends on how the intestinal cells are getting like shed or used in the lifetime, that affects the brain cells. Or in terms of us, it means that if someone is eating rajasic or tamasic food, it is directly affecting the brain throughout the life. That's a very intricate detail. But that's what it means. Okay, I'm going to break the break rooms and we can continue for some time, but I'll let the other co-hosts go. I can still sit for 5-10 more minutes. Does anyone has any other question? And whoever has to leave for other duties, please feel free to leave. You're not bounded to stay. Usha Mataji, you can unmute yourself.
I just wanted to find out the exact way how you turn that mala, which I couldn't follow because there was a lot of noise.
Yes. So, you see, this is a bead. Yes. And I'm chanting with my middle finger and thumb.
Yeah, that I know. But how do I turn? Yes. And I come in the end.
Yes, so I start here. I end here. Now I want to do one more round. So, the last bead becomes the first bead.
So I don't turn it.
Yes, I turn it. And then I go like this. So, this bead becomes the first and this bead becomes the last. And again, go and turn like that.
I turn it. So I have not to go over it. That is what I. Thank you. Thank you. Yes. Thank you, Mataji.
Thank you. Hare Krishna.
Mataji, can you tell us before Hare Rama, Hare Krishna, what is that Prabhupada?
Yes, let me, thank you. Let me bring up the prayer. It will be discussed tomorrow again and it will be available to you, but I can share in the group and share now also.
Ma'am?
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Ma'am, can you add 9182054521 to that group? Because that device is mostly
which group
with me.
Which group?
The English one.
The WhatsApp group?
Yeah.
You're not there?
I am there, but the device is with my dad. So I mostly don't use that device. So if you add that device is always beside me. So I can check the mail.
I think you have to ask permission from your father.
Okay.
Ask permission from your father and your father can message me and I'll be very happy to add you. Okay? Go through your father. Okay.
Love you, Isha.
Okay, so Mataji, this is the prayer. Shri Krishna Chaitanya Prabhu Nityananda Shri Advaita Gadadhar Shivasadi Gaurav Bhakti Vrinda. Okay? This is the prayer. Aishwarya and Roshan, if you have other duties to take care of, please feel free to leave. If you can stay, that will be great. But if you have something, please take. Yes, Mataji.
Okay. There were some questions which are unanswered, so I should stay, Mataji.
Okay, thank you. Okay. Yes, who is saying? Yes.
I just wanted to know about the 1 year courses. Like, I want to study deep Bhagavad Gita. Like, I want to read each and every shloka. Where can I get the details?
Okay, so we are going to launch Bhakti Shastri very soon, but I'm actually running two groups of detailed Bhagavad Gita. We started last week only. One is on Saturday, 6:30 India time, and next is Sunday, 1:30 India time. You can join us. You have to message me on WhatsApp and I'll add you.
How to join? How to join,
Mataji?
Mataji, Bhakti Vriksha also, no? Bhakti Vriksha.
The Bhakti Vriksha, Prabhu is not doing detailed Bhagavad Gita. Aishwarya, is Prabhu doing detailed Bhagavad Gita? Not to my knowledge. He's doing.
No, Mataji. He is doing important shlokas of Bhagavad Gita.
So, Prabhu,
how to join your class, Mataji?
Yes, so we already did 1 week, so we did one chapter half. You can message in the I will share the link in all WhatsApp groups. I think that way it is more simple than you all messaging me personally and I am replying to every message.
Yes, yes.
Thank you.
Okay, Hare Krishna. Okay, Roshan.
How can I join the group?
What?
How can I join the group?
Prabhu, I will share the link. I will share the link in WhatsApp group. Roshan, who was asking you the question? Do you know?
No, Mataji, I don't remember the name. But the question was, why can't Lord Vishnu incarnate, come in this material world himself to defeat the demons and all, and why does he take incarnation?
Yes. So I always encourage that please ask questions relevant to the today's discussion. What happens is that questions are asked, but the answers are already there in some chapters. So, but Roshan, please go ahead and you can answer that question.
Mataji, I have told that ki I'll ask Mataji about it.
Okay, so thank you, Roshan. The question is that why Vishnu is not coming in this thing. So, see, tomorrow we are already going to discuss. Kale dosh nidhi rajan asti hi ek mahan guna kirtana deva krishna se mukta sangha param brajet. The Kaliyuga is full of faults, but there is one good thing about this age. Kirtana deva krishna se mukta sangha param brajet. By chanting the holy name of Krishna, one can get liberated from all the dirty things. So Krishna is already here. It's a matter of us realizing it. Krishna is here in the form of his holy name. In the material world, if I say mango, 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 the mango name and mango fruit are two different things, right? But when I say Krishna, 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 Krishna name and Krishna person is one thing. It is up to me how purified I am to realize that. The acharyas are realizing chanting. Haridas Thakur Prabhupada appeared in Kali Yuga only. He is able to chant 3 lakh names. For us, chanting 16 rounds is also like a tedious work, right? How? Because we are doing offensive chanting. We are not attached. Now, Manishtha Rahu used to tell me, do you get taste? And he said, okay, are you chanting? Are you chanting? Do you get taste on your tongue when you chant? And I used to think, why Prabhu keeps on asking me taste on the tongue when you chant? He said, you get so taste, like taste in your tongue. And slowly, slowly, by his mercy, I got the taste. So it's an experience. When you chant and when Krishna is pleased with your chanting, then you will get the taste because Krishna is dancing on the tongue. So Krishna is here. Depends on how much am I available to him. He is available. And there's so many times we'll be discussing the same thing. But that's in nutshell. Krishna is already here. we don't
know. I have a question.
Yes.
So in the video that you showed, I don't know if it's relevant to the chapter, but I just two questions on that. One point was prior to the birth, for a few moments, the infant or the embryo remembers 100 births. And then, it's suffering. Like we've always been brought up to think that mom's womb is the safest place for the child. And it is getting attacked by all these things. I'm not trying to dispute it. I'm just trying to think because everything you have said has had a logical or a scientific reason behind it. So is that a misnomer? And then we've always been, my imperfect knowledge tells me like what I've learned is, you only have 7 births. So when they're talking about 100 births, what's the relevance behind those two?
Okay, so not every womb, not every fetus is remembering. There's a key word there. Only a fortunate soul remembers. It's past 100 births. And it's not a question of 100 births. We had many, many births. When Krishna was telling Arjuna yesterday that Krishna said, I spoke this Bhagavad Gita first to Sun God, and we calculated by maths that Sun God is about 12 million years old. Arjuna immediately asked, but you are my contemporary. You are almost my age. How can you say that you spoke it million years ago? Then Krishna answers that many, many births, both you and I have passed, but I can remember them and you have forgotten it. Just because I have forgotten it, it does not mean it didn't happen. It happened. For example, if I ask you when you were a 2-year-old little girl, what were you doing on September 17th? Whatever the time is over there. What were you doing? Will you remember? Will you remember? But does it mean that it never happened?
True.
So that way, that is the relevance. Only a fortunate soul can remember that I've been suffering from so many lifetimes. That chapter, 31st chapter in 3rd Canto Bhagavatam, is a Sankhya philosophy. Kapil Dev is preaching to his mother, Devahuti. And there that's why there's a calculation, 100 births. And the other part of the question is the womb is the safest place. So I'm a pediatrician. I've done MD pediatrics. I practice as a pediatrician. And I can tell you that the womb of a mother is, there's so many sufferings. Sometimes the mother is herself suffering because of the pregnancy. And the child is definitely suffering. Sometimes they don't get weight. Sometimes they have congenital problems like kidney disease, heart disease. They're very vigilantly monitored. Sometimes they have genetic diseases, and the worms. I get a very question that, okay, Bhagavatam says there are worms which attack the tender body of a child. So then people say the mother's womb is supposed to be aseptic. No worms, no germs. But that's not true. It's not true. Whenever you see a child born, most of the children have rash called erythema toxicum. You can Google it. Erythema toxicum is a rash, and then we take a scraping of the rash and see in the microscope, we see the cells called eosinophils. I don't know how much you're understanding, but these cells are found in the human body when they are attacked by some allergies or worms. These cells are not normally to be found on any part. So that means there are worms. So I am telling you, I'm just confirming the statement. Yes, it is happening because we see the effect when the child is born. But up to the day 5 or 7 of life, they have this rash, and the rash has eosinophils, which is deductive knowledge that happens only when the body is stuck by worms or somebody has severe allergies. Okay, so it's
thank you, Madam.
And so many people I've treated in my life with congenital infections, brain infection, born with a brain infection because it was transmitted to their body from mother's body. It's not.
Thank you, Madam.
Hare, Hare Krishna. Anybody else has any questions?
Yes, Hare Krishna.
Yes, when you say ask a question, I can give 5 more minutes. Roshan, do you want to take any other question? Did you have any other question unanswered?
Yes, Mataji. There was a question that why do we keep the index finger out while chanting?
Yeah, I mean, it's very simple. Because index finger is used to point people. It's your finger, each finger has its function. So this finger is used to insult. If I point at someone, you. So that's kind of like insulting. So we don't want to use that. Prabhupada taught like this. Mudra. That's why. Any other question which was unanswered from your class, Roshan?
Yes, and one last question was, what are the cantos in Srimad Bhagavatam?
Very nice question. Let's show them. So there are 12 cantos. Did you finish the question or did I interrupt you?
It is finished, Mataji.
Okay, so there are 12 cantos. See, go to vedabase.io, the Srimad Bhagavatam. Prabhupada translated up to 10 cantos, and 11th and 12th were translated after his departure by the disciples. So there are 12 cantos and there are 18,000 verses. And you can even purchase. Why not have this? So go to iskonmangaluru.com. I have 2 sets of Bhagavatam because I have 2 children and I'm going to write in my will. One is going to get one, another one is. This is a heritage. It needs to go. So you see, go to purchase books in iskonmangaluru.com and you can purchase Bhagavatam and it will be delivered to you. Different languages. Okay? Okay, I can take a few more minutes, 5 minutes more, if anyone has any other questions. NRM, Hare Krishna. Yes.
Hare Krishna, Mataji. This is Neha.
What's your name, Mataji?
Neha.
Hare Krishna.
So in the class today, you spoke about one chant and you explained it beautifully to say that one disciple went and complained about, I'm doing everything, but I'm unhappy, I'm doing for the nation and everything. I missed the latter part of it. I think I was swayed by, I'm also suffering. I'm trying to keep everybody happy. What was the solution and answer to it?
So that's Chaitanya Chaitamrita. I should bring up Kama Dhinam Katina Kalita Palita Durani Deshate Sham Jata Mai Na Karuna Na Kripa No Pashanti. This is only the first half. Kama Dhinam Katina Kalita. I am trying to satisfy my senses so religiously. And I'm trying to satisfy the senses of my family, my friend, my society, my nation. But they have Na Kripa, no mercy. Kamadhinam katina kalita palita durni desha desham jatamai na karuna no mercy na kripa no gratitude no thank you no pashanti no peace. They're not getting satisfied only. What should I do? That there is a second part of the verse which I don't remember. That's why I only said the first part. But the meaning of the second part of the prayer is now I have come to my senses. Please, and now I surrender unto your lotus feet. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, and please give me the real peace formula. I can share that verse in the group. Kama Dhinam. Right. Okay.
Thank you so much.
Hare Krishna. Okay, anybody else? Varshini, Mataji, you can unmute yourself. You are unmuted.
Hare Krishna, Mataji.
Hare Krishna.
Why should we chant Panchatantva mantra before Hare Krishna?
Yes, Roshan, you want to say? Why should we chant Hare Krishna Panchatantva? Roshan, you're there?
Yes, Mataji, I'm here.
Yes, why should we chant Hare Krishna Panchatantva Mahamantra?
to pay our respect to the Panch, the Gurus.
Yes, so that's very nice.
Mataji, because we take blessings of the devotees of the Lord before chanting his name.
Yes.
So, see, these are the five exalted devotees. Shri Krishna Chaitanya is Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself. Prabhu Nityananda, this one in the blue, that's Balram's incarnation. Advaita Gadadhar is Advaita Prabhu. Advaita, then Gadadhar, Shri Vasadi, Gaurav Bhaktivinda. So these are the names of all the five exalted personalities. They are chanting the name purely. So we take their blessings before we start chanting Hare Krishna. Their mercy, please bless me so I can chant purely. And also please forgive me for any of the offenses that I'm doing.
Yes.
Mataji, Vrinda is also a devotee.
Yes, she is very nice devotee. Yes.
Okay. No, I was not knowing. I'm just confirming. I was not knowing. Vrinda was also a devotee. Hence,
oh my God! Did you read the Tulsi Arti in Mangal Arti time? Vrinda, Tulsi Devi, Arti, Keshavastacha, Krishna Bhakti, Prado Devi, Satyavate, Namo Namaha. Vrinda.
Yeah, Vrinda means the Tulsi only.
Yes, Vrinda is
the
name of Tulsi
only. That's the prayer. Vrinda Tulsi Deviai, Priyai Keshavastacha. So she is very, oh my dear Tulsi Maharani, you are so dear to Keshava. Whoever worships you gets the pure devotional service. Yes.
Yes.
Okay, so
we as equal.
Yes. Rashmi Mataji, you have another question. Your hand
Mataji,
is raised.
There was another question.
Okay.
Why are there 108 beads in a mala?
So these are 108 exalted personalities. Last 8 beats represents Ashtashakhi. What is the meaning of the verse Hare Krishna Mahamantra? The meaning of the verse is, O Krishna, O energy of Krishna. Hare means energy of Krishna or Radharani. Please engage me in pure devotional service. Please engage me in your pure devotional service. That is the meaning of the verse Hare Krishna. Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare. So we are begging Krishna to engage him on Krishna's energy, Radharani, to engage us in his pure devotional service. So when we are begging, we are going through the devotees. We cannot go to Krishna directly. Krishna is unavailable. We cannot go to Krishna directly. So we are chanting on each bead, and 108 has a lot of Vedic significance, but I don't know what are the names of 108 devotees. I can tell you the names of the last 8 Sakhis, the very dear Sakhis in Mayapur temple. Let me see if I can show you.
Mataji, all the 108 are the gopis only, no? Of the
gopis.
Okay, I don't know. I have tried to look up Prabhupada's reference once, but okay, the devotees of Krishna is what I found. But yes, the gopis are devotees. Radha Madhav, Shri. See, I'll show you the
Ashtagopi.
Yes, the
DD that. Mataji, I am not part of the WhatsApp group of that your class. Then I will not be able to get the link of your Bhagavad Gita class.
Who is speaking?
Rashmi.
Mataji, you have my number?
No, Mataji.
So we have to get connected somehow. You email me ugenglish20@gmail.com.
Yeah, sure, I'll do that today, Mataji. Tomorrow is the class, right, Mataji? Tomorrow is the class, right?
6:30 in the morning. That's one, and then repeat classes on Sunday. See, these are the our deities in ISKCON Mayapur. Radha Madhav and all the Ashtasakhis. So beautiful. So they are arranged in the order. So Lalita, Vishakha are the two innermost. Near Radharani is Vishakha Sakhi. Near Krishna stands Lalita Sakhi. Okay. Okay, so we break now. Pancha Kalpatro Vyascha Kripa Sindhu Bhi Aivacha Patitanam Bhavanabhyo Vaishnavyo Namo Namaha.
Mataji, there is a last moment question. What is Ekadashi?
Yeah, you can answer that question. Can you?
Mataji, it is the 11th day from the Purnima or Amavasya. And it is the favorite tithi of Lord Krishna. So we should always try to fast during that day to please Lord.
Yes. So Ekadashi, so Krishna, see, every month we get some benedictions, like, okay, every day is auspicious. In Krishna consciousness, every single day is nothing but full of auspiciousness because we are going closer to Krishna day by day, day by day, day by day. But some days he gives us a jump start. You're doing, and then you get a kick. Okay, yeah, today I'm going to do more. So Ekadashi is one of those days. I don't remember, what is the conversation between Bhima and Krishna? But there was this conversation between Krishna and one of his devotees where they were asked that how can we come closer to you? So Krishna said that I'm going to make this day where you will be, if you dedicate more time in my service, then you will be able to come to me very easily. So Ekadashi is one of those days, and Krishna makes Papa Purusha enters the grains, and whoever eats grains on that day is actually equal to killing one's own parents and a cow if you eat someone's grains on Ekadashi. So we don't eat grains, and we chant more than usual, and very simple sattvic diet, and try to remember Krishna, and we become more strong in Krishna consciousness. Okay. Adhika Mas. Oh, Adhika Mas is an extra month made in leap year, and that month had nowhere to go. So we approached Krishna that I have nowhere to go. I am abandoned. I'm an orphan. Krishna said, I'm going to bless you by giving you my own nature. That is why Adhika Mas is also called as Purushottam month. And whoever will do devotional service in that month will surely attain my pure devotional service, which is Goloka Vrindavan. So that is the importance. And I've been telling and shouting everywhere I'm going that, let's say you go to market to buy something, but then you're waiting for a sale now, when it will be on sale and I will be able to buy it at a cheaper price. Like that, Adhika Mas is a detour from regular. Like if you do devotional service on Adhika Mas, the result is many, many fold. That is the auspiciousness, because we can go more near to Krishna easily. Okay, let's break now. Pancha Kalpa Trubhyascha.